What is happening, guys? In this video, we are gonna talk about Arwatatsumi Priestess Kokomi. In this video, I'll cover everything you need to know about her, from her best artifacts, weapons, playstyles, team camps, and at the end of the video, I'll give you my own thoughts about her as a character. So now, let's not waste any more time and let's get right into the subject at hand. Kokomi is a Hydro Catalyst user that applies the Hydro element pretty fast. Because of that, she can fill many different roles in your team, like an off-field enabler, carry, or an off-field support that can heal your other party members. Since Kokomi was already released and this is her first rerun, I will only mention briefly her skills and talents for the new Genshin boys. Her elemental skill will create a jellyfish that will deal hydro damage and heal nearby active characters based on Kokomi's max HP. The jellyfish will have a fixed location. Once you use it, it will remain in that spot for the entire duration. You could say this is the only bad thing about her elemental skill. The only positive thing about her jellyfish is that it applies hydro pretty fast. To give you an example, her Bakke Kurage will apply hydro faster than Mona's E. While in her elemental burst, Kokomi will enter into the ceremonial garment state, enhancing her normal, charge attacks and the jellyfish damage based on her max HP. During the duration of her burst, while she is in the ceremonial state, Kokomi's normal and charge attacks will restore HP for all party members, based on her own max HP. She will also receive resistance to interruption and she will be able to walk on water. In order to have 100% uptime on her burst, you need around 150 energy recharge on her. Moving on to her passive talents. She has a negative 100% crit rate and 25% healing bonus from the Flower Strategy's passive talent. You can crit with her, but you need to have a lot of crit rate on her artifacts. If her elemental skill is active on the field when she uses her elemental burst, her E duration will refresh. And lastly, while in her ceremonial state, her normal and charge attacks damage will further increase based on 50% of her healing bonus. Now that we cover her talents, let's get into the meat of this video and talk about some serious stuff. The first thing that I want to cover right away is her playstyle. She can be played as a main damage dealer, as a support, hydro applicator, or even as a healer. You'll probably think that I'm joking when I mention that she can be played as a DPS, but just wait.
But I'm not done yet!
To use her as a main DPS, you need some specific camps. One example is the teaser camp or even the reverse weapon. For the teaser camp, she will act as the main DPS, constantly applying hydro while your other units will apply electro off-field. I won't go into details about the characters since I want to address them in the team camp section, but some of her best characters for doing this job are Beidou and Fischl. You'll also need one Onimo user to have in the teaser camp, so you can increase the damage of both Hydro and Electro with the Vincent Venerer 4-piece artifact set. Now let's address the supportive role too, since I'm on this topic. For this one, you'll only want to use her for her elemental skill and burst, without utilizing too much your normal attacks. Her elemental skill is a very good hydro applicator. One example that I can give you is in a vaporized cup. Kokomi will place a re, then you will switch her out for a pyro user. Let's use Zhangling as an example since everybody will have her. With Kokomi's E hitting the target, Zhangling's burst can vaporize all the pyro tornado hits. So in short, all her burst attacks will get vaporized. This can also work in a Morgana cup. You'll only place her elemental skill, then you can switch to a cryo unit and do your thing. Let's take a look at her constellations, since many of you may already have her and are probably thinking if you should invest in them or not. Kokomi is a very F2P friendly and does not require any constellations to do her job. But even though if you have some of them, you won't get the same results as getting constellations for a main DPS like Radahn Shogun, for example. Her constellation will only provide her with damage increase to her normal and charge attacks, more hydro damage and more healing for both her elemental skill and burst. She will also gain 10% attack speed and more energy recovery. So in short, mostly all her constellations will increase her damage, but only if she will remain a lot of time on the field. If you are planning on using her as a support or a hydro applicator, her constellations are not that great. In my opinion, Kokomi is a character that does not require them. Her best in slot artifacts are without a doubt Tenacity of Millilith and Ocean Hued Cloud. You can use other variations as well, like Maiden or Heart of Depth, but I strongly recommend to use these two sets for her. The Tenacity of Millilith can work pretty well if you are planning to use her as a support by only utilizing her elemental skill. As long as her skill will continue to hit nearby enemies, all your party will gain a 20% attack increase. The requirement of this artifact set is not a big deal if you are using a Morgana cap, since your enemies will be frozen in place almost all the time. However, for a vape camp or a boss fight, sometimes it will be annoying because they will move around too much. So you want to, let's say, be a bit careful when you decide to trigger the 4-piece set attack bonus. In short, this is a very good artifact set for her, since it will increase her max HP by 20%, which equals more damage for her, and also it will increase all your party members' attack damage by 20%.
Oh my!
The best thing about running the 4-piece Tenacity of Millilith on her is that she can trigger the attack bonus by utilizing her jellyfish. She is not required to be active on the field.
Lovely.
If you want to spice things out, you can also add the Thrilling Tales of Dragon Slayer to the mix to get even more attack bonus damage. Now that I illustrated all the good and bad aspects of Tenacity of Millilith, let's move on to the Ocean Hued Cloud. This set is the one that you consider if you are planning on using her for her normal and charge attacks. In short, using your Kokomi as the main DPS. This artifact set can be used even if you only want to use her as a support, but you'll get better value if you stick to a DPS role. If you want to know the reason why, it's because as a DPS she can heal more often with both her jellyfish and her burst, compared with her playing as a support. Before moving on, I want to explain how the Ocean Hued 4-piece set actually works, because it has a lot of text in the description and many of you will get confused. The 4-piece set will summon a small bubble around her that will last around 6 seconds. The bubble will appear only while Kokomi will heal or overheal herself or other characters in your party. As I said, the bubble will last for around 6 seconds, and after that, it will explode, dealing AoE physical damage. The maximum amount of healing or overhealing that she can store inside the bubble is 30k. She cannot exceed that threshold. If you get to 30k before the 6 seconds have passed, the bubble will explode immediately and another one will take its place. So, as I said before, if you want your Kokomi to become the main DPS in your team, this set is the only one that you should use on her. You can also use the 4-piece Heart of Death as a second option, if you do not have good pieces for the Ocean Hue. Lastly, we have the Maiden Beloved. If you are in need of more healing, you can consider having the 4-piece Maiden, and you can also try mixing up other artifacts. For example, 2-piece Maiden and 2-piece Ocean Clam or Heart of Death. But, in my opinion, you are better off using the two that I mentioned above. Now that we are done with her artifact choices, let's talk about what stats you should prioritize on her. The main substats that you'll want to have on all your artifact pieces will be, of course, HP percentage and energy recharge. The rest won't matter that much. For her main stats, you'll want to have on her timepiece HP percentage, on her goblet hydro damage or HP, depending on your preference. If you want more damage, go for the hydro one. Instead, if you want more healing, use the HP one. As for her circlet, you'll want to go for her healing bonus one. If you do not have a decent healing mask, you could also consider an HP one instead. Hoyoverse decided to let us know what weapons are going to be during Kokomi and Raiden's banner, without having to rely on leakers. So as you can see, the Everlasting Moonglow will be available as well. So you may wonder, isn't this her best in slot weapon? Yes, of course it is. But the weapon at the moment will only benefit her and Barbara. So instead of pulling for her weapon, you can use other options. Some of her best weapons are the following: Prototype Amber, Thrilling Tales, and Hakushin Ring. In my opinion, the most universal weapon that you can use for her is without a doubt the Thrilling Tales of Dragon Slayer. Being a 3-star weapon, you can max refine it very easily, and you'll also benefit from the weapon buff from your other party members. This weapon also gives her HP percentage as a substat, and it will really benefit her entire kit. The second weapon that I want to talk about is a prototype Ember. This weapon will provide Kokomi with a lot of energy regeneration, which will help her a lot with her burst uptime, and it will provide additional healing to your party. The Hakushin Ring is more situational compared with the others. This weapon must be used in an electro camp, so you can receive the elemental damage bonus buff. If you only care about increasing Kokomi damage potential, you can use Kaiora's Atlas or even Last Prayer, but I won't recommend you to do so, since these weapons are copium for her at this point. We will get better results with the Thrilling Tail or even Prototype Ember. The Moonglow is her best in slot weapon, if you want to get the maximum amount of damage using her as a main DPS. But let me ask you this. Is this weapon worth all the Primo Gems? Let me know in the comment section. Kokomi is a very flexible character, and as I previously said, she can be used in a lot of team camps, depending on your own preference. Some good team camps that I can see utilizing most of her abilities are the Freeze Camp, Vape or Reverse Vape, and lastly being Sukokomon. The Freeze Camp, aka Morgana, is a perfect example for support Kokomi, and it will heavily rely on her elemental skill to debuff your enemies with Hydro so you can freeze them afterwards. Some good characters for this camp are Ganyu, Rosaria and an Animo user. You can use whoever you want, but the best one is without a doubt Kazuha.
Ame furu kaze no naka.
Since one of his talents can increase your other party members' elemental damage. Ganyu and Rosaria are versatile, and you can swap them however you wish. One example that I can give you is, instead of Ganyu, you can use Ayaka, or you can use Shenha instead of Rosaria. But if you want, and you have both Ganyu and Ayaka, you can use both of them without relying on other characters. Now that I covered the Morgana camp, let's take a look at the Vape one. For the Vaporize one, we have two scenarios. One is where your other Pyro users will trigger the Vape reaction, and the second one where Kokomi will trigger the reverse Vape reaction. In the first scenario, you'll want Kokomi to act as a Hydro applicator for your other Pyro users, since its duration is pretty decent and you can reset the duration with your burst. However, if you want to use Kokomi in a reverse Vaporize, you will need to have at least 2 Pyro units to manage your Pyro debuff more easily. Some good Pyro users that I can think of are Xiangling and Bennett. Xiangling is the best at applying the Pyro debuff with her burst, and Bennett increasing your team overall damage. As for the last part, in your party, you will want again an Animo user like Kazuha or Sucrose. The reverse Vape camp is a bit hard to pull, but it can seriously throw a punch. Let's take a look at the fan favorite, the teaser camp. This camp is way easier to manage than the reverse Vape one. Being that all the electro characters will do their own thing without you having to do anything at all. In short, you only need to use Kokomi's attacks to trigger the electro charge reaction. The best characters for this team camp are Fischl, Beidou and an Animo user like Kazuha, Sucrose or Venti. With Fischl, you'll only need to play Souls on the field. With Beidou, you'll only need to use her elemental burst. And with Kazuha, you want to swirl the Hydro and Electro elements while Kokomi triggers the Electro Charge reactions. This is a pretty fun to play team camp, and it is a really good choice if you want to use your Kokomi as the main DPS. The last camp that I want to mention is Sukokomon. This is without a doubt an underrated team. With this camp, you can trigger all kinds of reactions like Electro Charge, Overload and Vaporize. The problem that this camp has is that it requires to follow a specific rotation so you can bring out this team full potential. For the new Genshin players, this is a bit tricky to pull off in the beginning. Even for me, honestly, it's a pain to remember all the steps that you need to do so I can pull it off. But surely enough, if you repeat this team rotation over and over, it will go into your muscle memory. And eventually you'll do it automatically. So I want to use Sukokomon. What are the best characters used for this team camp? First, we have Fischl, Xiangling, Sucrose and Kokomi herself. So let me give you a quick rundown on how this team camp will work without going into too many details. First, you'll have to set up Electro Charge on your enemies. with Fischl and Kokomi. Then you'll have to place Gogba and swirl him with Sucrose. Then you'll need to swirl again with Sucrose, but this time you'll use it on the enemies to swirl all the reaction that you have so far. Then you switch to Xiangling and use her elemental burst. Switch to Kokomi and use her burst to optimize her Hydro appliance by using 2 normal attacks and 1 charge one. Then refresh Oz, place Gogba and swirl again with Sucrose. Then you'll have to start over again. Easy, am I right? For your information, in total, there are 16 steps that you need to follow in order to pull this off. This was only the TLDR version. If you want to know a step-by-step guide tutorial, let me know in the comment section and I'll make a dedicated video for this topic alone. So, overall, there are a lot of ways that you can play and utilize Kokomi. She can be played as a main DPS, utilizing the Ocean Clad set, or you can use her as a support with the 4-piece tenacity of Millileaf. Kokomi is a character that will not appeal to everybody, except the true fanboys out there. One of her core strengths is that her Hydro appliance rate is one of the best that we have so far in the game. Except for healing and applying the Hydro element pretty fast, she's not that great if we compare her with other 5 stars that we have currently in the game. So, with all of that being said, this has been a very detailed guide about our beloved Shrine Maiden Kokomi. If you have any questions about her, feel free to ask them in the comment section below. Don't forget to like this video and consider subscribing to my channel. I cover almost everything related to Genshin Impact, from builds to guides and discussion videos. Thank you all for watching and I'll see you all in the next one. Peace.